Come on in. Ain't nobody here but me.
Hey, Dad, wait up.
Hello there. Ain't nobody here but me.
Double look for air.
Take off your shoes, give your feet some air.
I know it's your summer.
You can even sit around in your underwear. Oh, come on
Hello?
In. Ain't nobody
what?
Here but
Don't
me.
Don't bother me now. I'm looking for Eric. It's for you.
Come on
Where
in.
He?
Ain't nobody
Where's
here but me.
Happy birthday, Kaley.
Thanks, Dad. You're having a surprise party for me today, aren't you?
What makes you think that?
You always have a surprise party for me.
Well, actually, I was going to have a surprise party for you, but everybody's busy. That's why it's just you and me for birthday dinner after school.
Uh-huh. I still think you're going to try to surprise me.
I don't know what this world is coming to when a daughter doesn't believe her own father. There's a couple more minutes before breakfast. Maybe you should get ready for school.
Okay, Dad.
Only you would do this, Eric.
What, make pancakes for breakfast?
No, I mean get everyone together for breakfast so that Kaley won't suspect that we're having a surprise party for her after school.
Dad, have you seen my vest?
It's in the kitchen. Here she comes. Act naturally. Look who's here, Marion the librarian.
Hi, Marion. I didn't hear you come in.
I've been reading a book about the ninja art of silent walking. Anyway, I just dropped by to wish you a happy birthday.
Thanks, Marion.
Come on in.
Don't worry, I won't say a thing about the surprise.
Look, it's Max and Andrea.
What do you say to Kaley?
Happy birthday, we love you.
Oh, thanks, you guys. I'm glad you popped in.
Happy birthday, Kay.
Thanks, Prue. Gee, this is becoming a regular party.
As long as we're all here, why don't you stay for some of my special birthday pancakes? Happy birthday, happy birthday, we love you. Happy birthday, and may all your dreams come true. When you blow out the candles, one light stays aglow. It's the love light in your eyes wherever you go.
Can I help blow out the candle?
Sure.
Don't forget to make a wish.
One, two, three.
Yay!
What did you wish for?
I can't tell you. Otherwise, it won't come true.
And now for a treat, my famous apple pancakes.
Hey, I thought the surprise party was this afternoon.
No! Don't you remember? No one could make it.
Yeah, and I have that meeting at the Trailer Park Board of Directors.
Yes, and I'm teaching my karate lesson at the library.
And I'm docked for something, so I can't go out tonight. But here's my present.
And this is from me.
And here's a little something from Max and me.
I have a present, but it's, still in the store.
That's okay, CJ.
Hey, speaking of presents, I heard on important royal birthdays, the king used to grant the little people special favors. So I was wondering, King Eric, if you might grant me a special favor and sign our contract.
This isn't the time for us to discuss business. This is Kaylee's day.
I was joking. It's getting kind of stuffy in here.
Well, I should be getting back to the library.
And I'll wait for you outside.
Max, I can say goodbye to you on the porch.
Thanks for the presents, everyone. Dad, should I pretend that I didn't hear what CJ said about tonight's surprise party?
Oh, come on, Kaley. You know that CJ always gets things wrong. Today, it's you and me after school for supper.
Sure, Dad.
Well, will you look at the time? You better get your book so you'll be late for school.
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
sorry I let the cat out of the bag about the party, Eric. I could kick myself.
Well, calm down, CJ. The surprise party's still on. We'll just have to go to Plan 2B.
Plan 2B? What is Plan 2B?
2B. Figured out later. I'll go tell the others.
Are you okay, Uncle CJ?
How could I be so stupid? I blow the surprise party, I make a fool out of myself by forgetting to buy her a present, and then, I top it all off by bringing up the contract. I've totally blown it with Eric.
Eric's not like that. He'll think of a way to get the surprise party tonight back on track. But it probably wouldn't hurt to buy Kaley a nice gift.
Hey, that's it. A nice present. Prue, you're a genius. I'll get her something really nice that'll make her forget what a jerk I was. What's Kaley into?
Surprises.
Well, I know that.
And ballet, of course.
I wouldn't know what to get her.
I know. When we were at the mall, she flipped over this figurine of a quarter horse.
Oh, forget the quarter horse. I'll go for the whole horse. It's gotta be big.
So today at lunch, we'll plan your half birthday, okay?
Hey, Eric. I figured out a way to make everything hunky-dory again.
CJ, nothing has to be fixed.
You've got Plan 2B. I've got Plan 2C.
What's Plan 2C?
2C is to be surprised. Kaley loves surprises, and I thought up the perfect surprise to surprise her in a really surprising way.
CJ, I hope you're not going to do anything foolish.
This is the smartest thing I've ever done. See ya.
Why do I think this spells trouble?
Dad, how come you didn't want to stay at the restaurant for dessert?
Well, I did plan a little surprise.
I knew it! You can't fool me. I bet everyone is waiting inside, ready to jump out and surprise me. Hello, everyone! There's no one in there!
Surprise!
This is the surprise?
Welcome to the house of Cassadel chez Eric.
May I?
Mais oui. I understand it is the young woman's birthday today.
May oui.
May I? Our birthday menu.
Is that not birthday cake on the menu?
But of course, the Cassadel chez Eric is famous for its birthday cake.
What gâteau de...
Gâteau de l'anniversaire is French for birthday cake.
What bolo de...
Bolo de anouche is a Portuguese for birthday cake.
And this?
This is Italian for birthday cake, and this is Chinese for birthday cake, and this is Hebrew for birthday cake. Has Mademoiselle made her decision?
Well, Dad, I think I'll have the birthday cake.
An excellent choice. I shall return in one moment, but first, your...
What's up?
Is Upper Bronx for noise maker.
Is everybody here?
Yes. Except for Uncle CJ, but I know he wanted to be here.
We can't wait.
Should we go out there and surprise her?
No, I'll figure out a way of getting her in here, and then it's Plan 2B.
Plan 2B.
Synchronize your voices.
Mademoiselle.
A whole cake just for me?
Well, it is difficult to believe that one person could eat it all.
Casa del Chez Eric doesn't seem to be very packed tonight. Would you like to join me?
Well, perhaps one petite morsel, voila. Ah! I am not off my feet for one moment when I see I have forgotten the forks.
That's okay. We can eat with our fingers.
Ah, and now I see I have forgotten the napkins.
That's okay. We can lick our fingers clean.
Is that the phone?
I'll get it.
Hello?
chicken in the living room?
But us chickens, there ain't nobody here at all. So calm yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. We chickens trying to sleep, and you bust in and gobble, 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 gobble with your chin. Bawka, 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 bawka.
There ain't nobody here but us chickens.
Bawka, bawka, bawka.
There ain't nobody here at all.
Bawka, bawka, bawka.
So calm yourself.
Bawka, bawka.
Stop that fuss.
Bawka, bawka, bawka.
There ain't nobody here but us.
We chickens trying to sleep, and you bust in and gobble, 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 gobble with your chin.
Tomorrow is a busy day.
We got things to do. We got eggs to lay.
We got worms to dig, ground to scratch.
It takes a lot of setting, getting chickens to hatch.
We chickens trying to sleep, and you bust in and gobble, 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 gobble with your chin.
This is great. Thanks, everyone. Dad, you fooled me.
I'm glad. It gets harder and harder every year.
Where's CJ?
Oh, he's coming.
I'll save him a piece of birthday cake. Where is it?
The cake!
Tomorrow is a busy day. We've got things to do. We've got eggs to lay. We've got worms to dig, ground to scratch. It takes a lot of setting, getting chickens to hatch.
There ain't nobody here but us chickens.
There ain't nobody here at all.
So calm yourself. Stop that fuss.
There ain't nobody here but us.
We chickens trying to sleep, and you bust in and gobble, 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 gobble with your chin. Take it home, chickens.
They make you look very sophisticated.
I love Mandria. Thanks.
You're welcome.
The card's from me. Look inside.
Oh, thanks, Prue.
What is it?
2 tickets to see this group public domain.
They are so hot.
But who could I possibly get to go with me?
Kaley, if you bring anybody but me to that concert, those tickets will self-destruct.
Just kidding, Prue. It wouldn't be the same with anyone but you.
This is for you.
Thanks, Max.
That's Max's favorite toy.
Max, if there are any fires in the neighborhood, just call me.
This is for me.
It feels like a book.
It's a very special book because it's a book about you.
How could it be about me?
Open it and see.
It's a diary.
Read the inscription.
To my dearest Kaley, may this book be big enough to hold all your adventures. But Marion, I don't have adventures.
Well, you may be surprised to hear this, but when I was your age, I felt the same way.
You told me that you grew up on a South Sea island. And didn't you even save your baby brother from a shark once?
Yes.
And did you save your whole village from a volcano?
Uh-huh. And then there was the time that I discovered the lost pirate treasure in the undersea cave. But that's another story.
That's what I mean. You had tons of adventures.
Yes, but at the time, I thought my life was nothing special. And then, one day, a good friend of mine gave me a diary, and I started writing in it every day. And then I read back what I had written, and I realized I do have adventures.
Do you think the same thing could happen to me?
I know it will.
I'm beginning to get a little worried about Uncle CJ.
Surprise! Oh. Guess you did that already.
I'm glad you made it, CJ. I saved you a piece of cake.
Later. Now close your eyes. I'm gonna lead you outside. Surprise!
I can't believe it. This is for me?
is mind-boggling.
Can I ride him?
It's a mare.
Not only is it a mare, it's a female horse.
A mare is a female horse.
I knew that.
You got Kaley a horse for a birthday present?
Great gift, eh, Eric? I mean, is this a surprising surprise or what?
This is the best birthday surprise ever.
So, you think she was surprised?
Definitely.
Guess I'm back in the fold, huh?
CJ, can I talk to you? Inside?
Well, sure, Eric, old buddy, old pal. Ha ha.
I can't believe you actually got a real horse for your birthday. This'll be running to school any day.
Know much about horses, little lady?
Not really, but I'm a real fast learner. What's her name?
Brownie.
Did you name her that because she's such a lovely shade of brown?
Nope.
Because she has such beautiful, intelligent brown eyes?
Nope.
Why did you name her Brownie?
Because my name's Brown.
Oh.
And this horse is just like family. I mean, she used to be.
CJ, I can't believe you got Kaley a horse for a birthday gift.
Ha! I knew she'd love it.
Sure she loves it, but you should have checked with me first.
But why? Did you want to buy her one?
No, CJ, we live in a trailer park. We're not set up for a horse.
You're not?
Well, where are we going to keep her? How are we going to feed her?
Those are all very good questions, Eric.
And you should have thought of them before you got a horse. Now you're going to have to give the horse back.
But I'm not sure Mr. Brown will take Brownie back. It's not like returning a sweater.
Well, then you'll have to find somebody else to take her.
I'm not giving her back.
But your dad says we have no place to keep her.
We can build a shed. I'll help.
I wish we had the space to keep a horse, but we just don't.
I'm sorry, Kaley.
This is the worst birthday surprise ever.
Oh, I should have bought a quarter horse. Then I'd only have a quarter of the problem. Oh.
Why do you always have to spoil my fun? Why can't you ever treat me like a grown-up? You think I'm still a child. I can take care of a horse.
Uh-huh.
When am I ever going to be able to do what I want? When am I ever going to have what I want?
Uh-huh.
I'm a young woman now. When are you going to treat me like one?
Uh-huh.
Well, when?
You feel better now?
No. Dad, when will I be old enough to have a horse?
Well, Kaley, I'm not old enough to have a horse.
What?
I wanted a horse when I was a kid. I still want a horse.
You do?
Sure. A horse would be great. You could ride it to school. I could ride it to my concerts.
Then let's get one.
But I know a horse wouldn't be right. For us or for Brownie. The only difference between you and me is you have a dad to tell you that. Me, I have to tell myself no.
Dad, I still want one.
Maybe we could compromise. Just because we can't have a horse doesn't mean we can't go riding. Why don't we treat ourselves to riding lessons for our birthday?
That would be fantastic. Only, it's not your birthday.
It's almost my half birthday. I could join you for riding every other week.
Okay.
Why, you old horse thief?
What's going on?
He wants me to pay him to take Brownie back. I can't believe it.
Well, do you have room for her?
Yes, sir. She can have her own stall back.
Is there something you don't like about her?
No, sir. I've been feeling awful since I sold her.
So what's the problem?
There's no problem. I'm just trying to give this young fella a hard time about what he did.
So next time he'll think twice before buying an animal he doesn't know how to care for.
Yes, sir. It's not like returning a sweater.
Do you think I could brush Brownie once more before Mr. Brown takes her away?
Sure. And while you're at it, Brownie looks kind of hungry to me.
What do horses eat?
Well, mares eat oats.
Oh, Dad.
Mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy. A kiddly divey too, wouldn't you? Mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy. A kiddly divey too, wouldn't you? If the words sound queer and funny to your ear, a little bit jumbled and jivey, sing, mares eat oats, and does eat oats, and little lambs eat ivy. Oh, mares eat oats, and does eat oats, and little lambs eat ivy. A kiddly divey too, wouldn't you?
I get it. Mares eat oats,
and does eat oats, and little lambs eat ivy.
Yeah, and pigs eat eggs, and bears eat eggs, and little bears eat omelets. And of course, there's also frogs eat ants, and toads eat ants, and little toads eat dunkles. If the words sound queer and funny to your ear, a little bit jumbled and jivey, sing, mares eat oats, and does eat oats, and little lambs eat ivy. Oh, mares eat oats, and does eat oats, and little lambs eat ivy. A kid'll eat ivy too, wouldn't you? Here's another one. Whales eat eels, and seals eat eels, and little fish eat oysters. A squid'll eat oyster too, wouldn't you? Got it? Ready? Whales eat eels, and seals eat eels, and little fish eat oysters. A squid'll eat oyster too, wouldn't you? If the words sound queer and funny to the ear of all of you girlsters and boysters, sing, whales eat eels, and seals eat eels, and little fish eat oysters. Oh, whales eat eels, and seals eat eels, and little fish eat oysters. A squid'll eat oyster too, wouldn't you? A squid'll eat oyster too, wouldn't you? A squid'll eat oyster too, wouldn't you?
Bye, Brownie. I'll come and visit you soon and dream about you.
Bye, Mr. Brown.
Bye, Kaley. Happy birthday.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks for the special day.
I'm really sorry about this. I wanted to get you something special so, you know, you'd think I was special.
CJ, you remember you mentioned earlier about how the kings on royal birthdays would grant special favors? Well, today's your lucky day.
You're gonna sign the contract.
No, I'm going to forgive you for all the foolish things you've done today.
And then you're gonna sign the contract.
CJ, don't look a gift horse in the mouth. So how did you like your birthday?
I loved it. It was one surprise after another.
Where are you going?
To get my diary. I think I've just had my first big adventure.
Say so long. We'll meet again someday, and we'll sing another song. Don't say goodbye, just say so long. Don't say goodbye, say so long. Don't say goodbye, just say so long. We'll meet again someday, and we'll sing another song. Don't say goodbye.
This has been a CJ Cambium production.
I knew that.